Want to speak real French from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at FrenchPod101.com.
Hi, watchers! Are you coming to France soon? Because this week we are going to learn about 20 travel phrases you should know. Merci, thank you. Anytime you receive something or someone was nice to you, merci, thank you. Excusez-moi, excuse me. Anytime you bump into someone, or if you step on the foot because the metro is crowded, or if you need to call for the waiter's attention, use this one. Excusez-moi. Combien ça coûte? How much is this? Yeah, sometimes you won't find the prices on the items you are looking for, especially if you're going to a flea market in France. So just go, ah, this item, how much is it? Cet objet, combien ça coûte? Où est la gare? Where is the train station? This one can be quite convenient. If you are in a big city, where is the metro? Où est le métro? Le Wi-Fi est-il gratuit? Is the Wi-Fi free? If you want Wi-Fi in France, maybe some coffee shops now have it. They advertise it on the chalkboard outside. So come inside, we have Wi-Fi. Je voudrais ceci. I'd like this. Oh, I'd like this, please. Je voudrais ceci, s'il vous plaît. If you don't know the name of the item you want in the menu, you can just point and say, je voudrais ceci. I want this, please. Pourrions-nous avoir le menu, s'il vous plaît? Could we have the menu, please? Usually you have to ask for it. Sometimes the place is very crowded, so ask. Le menu, s'il vous plaît. Could we have the menu, please? Avez-vous des recommandations? Do you have any recommendations? If you are at a bar and want for some cocktail, can be like, oh, I like something fruity. Do you have any recommendation? J'aimerais quelque chose de fruité. Avez-vous des recommandations? And then the bartender will make you some fancy cocktail. Je suis allergique aux cacahuètes. I'm allergic to peanuts. If you have any allergies, be sure to ask whenever you are going out or trying to eat something. People will be really nice about it, and sometimes it's even on the menu. If you have any allergies, there will be a sign saying, yes, this contains nut, or this contains milk, or this contains gluten, and you can make sure that you don't eat something you don't want to ingest. Avez-vous des plats végétariens? Do you have any vegetarian dishes? If you're vegetarian or vegan, there will also be a sign very often on the menu saying this dish contains no meat, or this is vegan safe, it's made with no animal grease or eggs or milk. Pourrais-je avoir l'addition? Could I have the check? Pourrais-je avoir l'addition, s'il vous plaît? Could I have the check, please? Prenez-vous la carte de crédit? Do you take credit card? Can I pay by credit card? Puis-je payer avec ma carte de crédit? Pourriez-vous me prendre en photo, s'il vous plaît? Could you take a picture of me, please? What, you don't have your selfie stick? Come on, that's something every traveler should have. 1, 2, 3, whistiti! Je voudrais un siège non-fumeur, s'il vous plaît. I'd like to have a non-smoking seat, please. Well, restaurants in France have banned smoking inside for a couple of years now. So every restaurant you go to should be non-smoking. Smoking is only allowed in bars. Good luck with that. Do you have non-smoking seats? Avez-vous des sièges non-fumeurs? Pourriez-vous me donner un rabais? Could you give me a discount? Un peu moins cher? A little bit cheaper? This is again if you go to flea market, and especially on Sundays, you will have a bunch of sellers selling stuff from their homes. You can negotiate the price a lot over there. And getting an item half price is really common. So you can say, un peu moins cher. Ou, est-ce que je pourrais avoir un rabais? S'il vous plaît, give me a discount, please. Or make it cheaper, a tiny bit cheaper. Okay, more cheap, even cheaper, way cheaper. Okay, give it to me, free, now. Pourrais-je obtenir un plan? Could I get a map? Plan would be more map of something you want inside, for example, if you're in a museum. And if you're outside and got lost and go to the information center, for example, you can ask, pourrais-je avoir une carte? Could I get a map? J'ai une réservation. I have a reservation. When you get to a restaurant and have a reservation, they will often ask you at the front desk, so do you have a reservation? Avez-vous une réservation? You can say, yes, I have a reservation. Oui, j'ai une réservation. Puis-je essayer? Can I try this on? Yeah, if you want to try some clothes, you can ask the staff. Puis-je essayer ceci? Can I try this? Parlez-vous anglais? Do you speak English? French people aren't really good at speaking English, but they will try their best. So if you find someone and cannot express yourself in French properly and ask them, Parlez-vous anglais? Do you speak English? They may say, No, not that much, but no, je ne parle pas beaucoup, ou je ne parle pas anglais. The most common sentence I learn in every language is, A beer, please. Une bière, s'il vous plaît. Anytime it's summer, it's hot, and you want something fresh, une bière, s'il vous plaît. A beer, please, to go with your nice meal, or just to freshen up and chill with friends. So that's it for this week. What's your most used travel sentence? Leave me a comment to let me know. And if you want to learn more French, don't forget to check the website, frenchpod101.com. We'll see you next time.
See ya. Travel time.
Okay, so welcome back to French Weekly Words, and we are going to start this week with a new theme, and let's discover it together. French cities. Cannes is very famous for the film festival, right? Simple sentence would be, Le festival de Cannes a lieu en été. The film festival of Cannes is in summer. And you get to see a lot of celebrities and things like that. I guess because I never went there. Next one. Paris. So everyone knows Paris, I think. Paris is the capital. You have Eiffel Tower and fancy stuff, museum. Paris, la plus belle ville du monde. Paris is the most beautiful city in the world. They say as well. I find it smelly, but you can sing whatever you want. Marseille. Marseille is in the south and it's near Italy. It's a harbor kind of city. And it's kind of dangerous as well, but it's kind of fun also. La ville de Marseille est un port. Marseille is a harbor, right? Next one is Nice. It's written as nice, and it's also a nice city. So it's also in the south, so it's very sunny, and you have fancy food and fish, stuff like this. La ville de Nice est ensoleillée. Nice is sunny. Shall I say it more seriously? Montpellier, hey, I came from here. Montpellier, so this one is in the south, near the Mediterranean Sea. You have the mountain on the side and the sea on the other side. And it's super nice. It's a student city. And so a lot of young people. You have plenty of parties and things like that. Universities. And I really like it. So Montpellier est une ville estudiantine. Montpellier is a student city. The end. Okay, so we review all the cities today, and so don't forget to check the website if you want the list of cities and more information. So see you next week. Bye. Welcome back to French Weekly Words, and let's discover this week's theme. It's the end. French tourist attractions. I don't go out. I don't know those. First word is La cathédrale de Notre-Dame de Paris. Notre-Dame Cathedral, which is also in Paris, and it's the biggest one in France. It's pretty old, and you have nice artwork inside, and all the window artwork as well. I don't know what you call this in English. Window artwork. Stained glass. You have really pretty stained glass. On peut écouter l'orgue à la cathédrale de Notre-Dame de Paris le dimanche. So you can listen to the organ at Notre-Dame Cathedral on Sunday. It's very famous pianist here doing the organ. Next one. Musée du Louvre. So Louvre Museum, which is also in Paris, and it's famous for its pyramid shape. And you can also see Leonardo da Vinci and La Joconde inside. Also, they have a nice Egyptology place you can visit. Ma section préférée au Musée du Louvre, c'est l'égyptologie. My favorite part in Louvre Museum is Egyptology, which is really super interesting. Parc du Château de Versailles. Gardens of Versailles. There was a place where the king lived in, and really beautiful gardens with fountains and fancy architecture. And you can visit the castle as well, which is pretty beautiful. The best time to visit Gardens of Versailles is in summer. So, le meilleur moment pour visiter le parc du Château de Versailles, c'est en été. Because otherwise it may be raining and not so enjoyable, and in summer they put the fountains out and it's pretty. Mont-Saint-Michel. So this is in Bretagne, and if you know Bretagne, it's shaped like this, and it's at the end. And it's an old abbey built on a rock on a kind of island. So when the sea rises, you can't access it except by boat. And when it goes down, you can access it by foot. And you have to be careful with the sea because it's a bit dangerous over here. Le Mont Saint-Michel est une abbaye. Mount Saint-Michel is an abbey. Tour Eiffel. Eiffel Tower. It's red and white. No, it's not. So this was made for the International Exposition and it's a symbol of Paris as well. La Tour Eiffel est en forme de A parce que c'est la première lettre du mot amour. So Eiffel Tower is in the shape of the L letter because it's the first letter of the word love in French, amour. So they have the same shape. Next one is the end. So we'll see you in the next video next week for more French words. And if you liked it, you can leave a comment and don't forget to get the list of words from the website. So see you next time. Bye. 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 Welcome back to French Weekly Words. This week's theme is crossing borders. I like crossing borders. Traverser les frontières. First is douane, customs.
You don't like them customs.
To enter a country, you need to go through customs. Pour entrer dans un pays, vous devez passer par la douane.
Ah, how do you say?
Don't bring anything the custom could take away from you. N'emportez rien avec vous que la douane pourrait vous prendre. Next, formulaire de déclaration. Declaration form. Please fill the declaration form. S'il vous plaît, remplissez le formulaire de déclaration. You fill the declaration form, give it to the customs, enter the country. Remplir le formulaire de déclaration, le donner à la douane et rentrer dans le pays. Next. Nationalité. Nationality. Nationality. What's your nationality? Quelle est votre nationalité? My nationality is French. Ma nationalité est française. So you just replace French with your own nationality. Next. Passeport. Passport. Almost the same, so easy. I like having many stamps in my passport. J'aime avoir plein de tampons dans mon passeport. So when you enter in France, you give your passport, you get a fancy stamp, and you can show it to everyone after this. Next, visa, which in French is visa. What? Postuler pour un visa, to apply for a visa. Or getting a visa is complicated. Avoir un visa, c'est compliqué. So much paperwork and patience. Next is the end. So once you've crossed your border and go to custom and get your visa and went to quarantine, you're free to enter the country and welcome to lovely France. So enjoy your stay. I'll see you next week. Bye.
Hey, and welcome back to French Weekly Words. So this week's theme is tourism. Le tourisme. Let's go and visit stuff. Tourist. 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 Bingle. Yeah, in front of the monument. French tourists are noisy. Les touristes français sont bruyants. You can spot them miles away from anywhere because they are the ones screaming. Faire le touriste. Being all touristy. Click and photographing stuff and being loud. Okay, next one. Guide touristique. Guidebook. I always take a guidebook when going to another country. Je prends toujours mon guide touristique quand je vais visiter un nouveau pays. A tour guide, explaining stuff to you, it will also be a guide touristique. C'est recommandé dans le guide touristique. It's recommended in the guidebook. Next one. Visiter. To tour. My kitchen! You should tour my kitchen, it's so awesome and delicious. Vous devriez visiter ma cuisine, il y a plein de choses délicieuses dedans. I can cook, but I don't want to. To tour Paris. Visiter Paris. Go on, it will be fun. And pretty. I'm touring the museum. I'm going to the museum. Yeah. Église. Church. To go to church. Aller à l'église. On Sunday, usually. Do you tour this? There are a lot of miracles in Lourdes Church. Il y a beaucoup de miracles à l'église de Lourdes. Next. Itinéraire. Itinerary. Itinerary. To decide on the itinerary. Décider d'un itinéraire. Or to plan an itinerary. Planifier un itinéraire.
And it's the end for this week. So leave me a comment about what would you want to visit in France.
So welcome back to French Weekly Words. And this week's theme will be about at a hotel. So what do you do at a hotel? First one is key, la clé. So getting your key, recevoir sa clé. So you go, you check in, you get your key. Yeah, don't lose your key. Ne perdez pas vos clés. Or to open the door with the key. Ouvrir la porte avec la clé. Next one. Ah, okay. Single bed, un lit simple. So single bed. Single bed are so tiny. Les lits simples sont tout petits. Single bed for one person room. Un lit simple pour une chambre pour une personne. Yeah, even when I'm traveling by myself, I usually get double bed because it's the same price. And it's bigger and you can roll in it. Single bed is so small. Well, next one then is double bed. Lit double. Double bed are for two people. Les lits doubles sont pour deux personnes. Or for just one person if you like myself and like to roll in your bed. And be like me. I like double bed. J'aime les lits doubles. Next one. Occupé. No vacancy. There is no vacancy. L'hôtel est occupé. There are no room left. I had to sleep in my car because there was no vacancy. J'ai dû dormir dans ma voiture car l'hôtel était occupé. This is a sad thing, but sometimes it happens. Next one. Clé électronique. Electronic key. Most of the hotel have them, right? And you just swipe your key. Fancy! This is an electronic key, but this one is not for a hotel. It's for my room. To swipe your electronic key. Passer sa carte électronique. So you swipe it in front of your door. Nya, nya, nya. Please enter. Electronic key. Clé électronique. So welcome back and let's start this week with a new team that's in an airplane. I love airplanes. They're like, dans un avion. In an airplane. Let's go. First word is airplane. Avion. I love airplane. J'aime les avions. Traveling by airplane. Voyager en avion. Airplane meals. Les repas dans l'avion. People say they don't like them, but I like airplane lunch. First class. Yeah, première classe. This is where you get the champagne. First class seats are wide. Les sièges de première classe sont larges. And they have a nice big TV. And they can bend the seat like that and sleep. I so want to travel first class once in my life. Next one. Hôtesse de l'air. Flight attendant. There is a comic in France about a flight attendant. It's called Natasha Hôtesse de l'air. And you can read it. It's cute and nice, and it's an adventure around the world of this flight attendant called Natasha. Go check it out. I wanted to be flight attendant. Je voulais être hôtesse de l'air. Flight attendants must like traveling. Les hôtesses de l'air doivent aimer voyager. What? Come on! Sick bag. But in French, it's so disgusting. It's called vomit bag. So sac vomitoire ou sac à vomi. This is disgusting. Use a sick bag when throwing up. Utiliser un sac à vomi quand on vomit. I never seen people actually using them because flights are kind of comfortable now. Yeah, sick bags. Next. Next one. What? Compartiment bagage au-dessus des sièges. Overhead storage compartment. You don't need the overhead part in French, just compartiment. Put your luggage in the luggage compartment. Mettre les bagages dans le compartiment à bagages. And be careful when you open the storage compartment because it can fall on your head. Faites attention quand vous ouvrez le compartiment à bagages car les bagages peuvent vous tomber sur la tête. It's the end! Have a nice flight, everyone, and try those words when you fly to France. So yeah, leave me a comment about your airplane experience. So welcome back to French Weekly Words, and this week will be about currency exchange. Let's start. First one is convertir, to convert. Converting money, convertir de l'argent. Foreign exchange, devise étrangère. When you get to a new country, you should change your monies in foreign exchange. Quand on arrive dans un nouveau pays, il faut changer sa monnaie en monnaie étrangère. You can order foreign exchange at your bank before going. On peut commander des devises étrangères à la banque avant de partir. Next one. US dollar. Dollar américain. Mudica. US dollar are green. Les dollars américains sont verts. Here you go. Yeah. US dollar. $1. Having your first US dollar in your pocket is good luck. Avoir un, votre premier dollar dans la poche est un signe de chance. So more of them will come. Next one. Currency. Devise. To buy currency. Acheter des devises. And then you can trade them and make more money. So pièce. Coin. Let's flip a coin. And fail. Lancer une pièce de monnaie. To flip a coin. Ooh. So heads or tails. Tails, I'm sorry. You lose. Having many coins in your wallet. Avoir beaucoup de pièces dans son porte-monnaie. I'm so rich. Oui! And it's the end. So, how many money do you need to change when you go to a new country? And how much do you spend? Or what's your experience about exchanging currencies? Leave us a comment, check the word list, and we'll see you next week for more French words. Bye!